just gotta give a heads up. I played for about a half hour offline because, well, I was wanting to play and no point in streaming for a half hour. So, because I only had a half hour to kill. So, I did do a little bit of stuff, you can tell, because I have a little bit more experience. Still not enough to buy one of my chests, but that's okay. Basically, what I did, well, I'll show you everything I did while I was offline. It wasn't a lot. It basically had to do with the towers I built at the entrance a little bit. Started the maze, basically. Because all I had to do was, last time I, just before I left off, wasn't long till a night. So I played until the night, did the defense, and now it's dawn. And basically, as you can tell, there's still plenty of enemies around. Basically, I started the maze up and back, and some walls here, some of the big walls, I can't think what they're called off the top of my head. Whatever, they're bugging me. Okay, curtain wall. Build some curtain walls here because ghosts, specters don't pass through curtain walls. And then by putting those there, I can force the specters to at least walk near the towers instead of walking up over... Wow. That was cute. Instead of walking up on this side over here, because the specters have been walking through the wall and coming up like this, so half my towers don't get a shot at them. I mean, some of them do. But if I put this curtain wall here, it'll force them all to walk at least to here. I mean, the specters will just walk straight through where everything else will path around. Also, you can see that while I was playing for that half hour this morning, my wave makers have been busy. Curtain wall is still done down there. Nothing has attacked it, so starting to build some stuff over here to basically corruption resistance to prevent the curtain wall, the corruption from forcing itself through the curtain wall. See, I'm gonna have to build a lightning rod off to the left here to prevent, because I have to expand that way to prevent corruption from coming in that way, or monsters just spawning over there, because I don't own that area, so monster can still technically spawn over there, so I gotta work my way that way. Of course, you gotta have lightning rods around your stuff, otherwise, unless you want your stuff damaged by lightning. And yes, I don't know why, but I like having the range up at all times. Wow, my crystals ain't doing so good. Oh, and I pissed off the monsters. I had so much essence floating around that I needed to use some, so I'm like, oh, let's go play with a lightning storm. And there was a patch of green like this one, but it was like over here somewhere, and I cast it, and as you can see, well, they've repaired a lot of the damage. Which of course probably is going to enrage them and make this even harder. Now, if I can manage to, if I, since I built the one, if I can manage to build another wall across, like maybe come right across here and up, and then put something again behind it to prevent the corruption from going that way, that would ensure I have half the map to, at all times. Granted, I still need to build my corruption resistance over here, but that's a lower priority because it'll take a while for the corruption to get that far. Interesting, I don't normally have that much trouble finding it. Well, it's clearly not over here because my buildings aren't being damaged, but the question is where. Oh, there it is. Oh, it's good that it does. It apparently doesn't damage curtain walls. I actually ran out of cut stones. Hmm. was not expecting that. Oh man, not another one of these nights. Okay, well, my internet's sucking tonight, apparently. Sorry to everyone watching, because it looks like I'm dropping frames. Unfortunately, it is my internet, and there's not much I can do about it. Some nights I have my internet's not bad, some nights it is. Thankfully, normally, because of how late I stream, normally my internet's good at this time of night. But if it's bad, unfortunately, there's not much I can do about it. I'm hoping once the roads are upgraded to that level, that the stone pathway, that they don't really need. I mean, they probably need repair or something around them, but hopefully not more stone, because I'm out of cut stones. Really, three of them walked all the way out here to pick up two stones that happen to be laying over here? What? Well, two of them walked out here, and the other one's the wife of one of the ones that walked out here. Yeah, I'm really sorry, peoples. I have no control over when my internet decides to be bad. It is confirmed that it is my internet. It is my internet provider. The last few times that it happened, I actually went through a full network reboot, full nine yards, ping plotter and everything. And after getting frustrated, making sure it wasn't my network, I plugged the internet straight into my computer, and everything still was exactly the same. So it's my internet, and it goes bad on me like this sometimes, and unfortunately, nothing I can do about it. I just gotta hope it straightens out. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Wow, it's really bad, isn't it? Wow. I just actually tried opening the stream on my cell phone to see how bad it actually is. probably isn't even very watchable, losing so much, dropping so many frames. Oh, look at that. Looks like my stream, my internet actually strained out. Doesn't look like I'm dropping frames anymore. Oh, good. Sometimes my internet does that, sometimes it, and it gets really irritating. But it looks like it's straightened out now. Uh-oh, all of my essence collectors but one is popping low energy. Oh. The one's still full though. My towers haven't decided low energy yet though. Uh-oh, popping low energy in a lot of them now. Night's not over yet, stupid winter nights. They last longer than a normal night, and the summer night, obviously.